Landscape contractors and maintenance personnel are often confronted with the task of staking sprinklers in a turf area with an irregular shape. There is a tendency to let the sprinklers follow the form of the shape rather than imposing a consistent geometric grid with the sprinklers. The problem with following the irregular shape is sprinkler spacing becomes compressed or stretched to meet that dimension. That results in areas of over or underwatering, leading to maintenance issues and wasted water from runoff. In this video, we'll give you some tips on how to properly space sprinkler heads in an irregularly shaped area. Sprinkler head layout is typically achieved with a 100-foot tape or a measuring wheel that can sometimes lead to measuring errors, whether it be incremental or slipping of the measuring wheel. We've developed a simple tool that is nothing more than a surveyor string with loops at even increments. Depending on the head spacing that you'll need for a particular project, it's a good idea to have multiple rolls of string with loops tied off at different increments to match the throw of the nozzles most commonly used. Typically, 10, 12, 15, 20, and 35-foot increments will meet the majority of your needs. To determine which string line increment to use, we first need to measure the area by its length and width. Our goal is to select a head spacing that can be multiplied to equal the length of your longest edge. For example, a 100-foot run would work well with a 10 or 20-foot head spacing, where 12-foot spacing would not. Start by anchoring the string along the longest edge, starting where the head placement is most critical. For example, where overspray is least desirable. Run the string in a straight line, parallel to the edge, until you reach the loop that's closest to the opposite end of the turf without going past the edge. Now make a 90-degree turn into the irrigated area by one loop, then reverse direction to create another row parallel to the first. Continue doing this until you've created a grid that covers the full width of the area. As I mentioned before, your goal is to create a grid of even spacing within the irregular shaped area, whether it is square or equilateral triangle. Once you have your string line laid out, place a flag next to each loop to mark the placement of the heads in your grid. While we have achieved the objective of establishing a consistent geometric grid over the vast majority of the area, because of its irregular shape, we'll have some gaps. In order to address this problem, we will need to add some backup heads, also known as kicker heads, along these edges. These areas will receive a bit more water, but the alternative is to stretch spacing, resulting in dry spots and increased runtime. Proper head spacing is a critical aspect of the irrigation design, but there's more to learn. Sign up for one of our live classes at ewingirrigation.com.